point. Holding on your command. The signal's coming from a mine?
This smells.
I agree. The probe did not crash. Someone moved it here.
They may not know what they have. Let's find it before they set it off.
Right.
I'll stay right here.
Okay. It's okay.
That was a detonator. Someone just screwed us.
Shepard, at last.
You have me at a disadvantage.
My name is Ilanos Heliot. I doubt you know it. Who do you think runs the Terminus Clan, Shepard, huh? Thousands of pirates, slavers, criminals of every stripe.
I don't study the internal politics of pirate bands.
The strongest leads? The one who kills the most men, seizes the most ships, pillages the most colonies. 3 years ago, I was the strongest. I used my influence to assemble a fleet. We would drive your kind out of the Verge.
You're the one behind the attack on Elysium.
I was the motivator, the instigator, the one who promised glory and riches for sacking the largest human colony in the cluster. The one blamed when it failed. Failed! I was ruined when your kind held against the Blitz. What better way to recover my reputation than by eliminating the first human specter?
My crew will come for me.
Oh, let them. We'll be ready. An Alliance warship would make a fine prize. Oh, and if you haven't noticed, the oars here are laced with heavy metals. I'm afraid your suit radios aren't powerful enough to transmit out.
It doesn't have to be like this, Heliot.
Empty words from a dead man. Goodbye, Shepard.
What do we do now, Shepard?
No one panic, just scream.
We got air and light, and the Normandy's still in orbit. Let's look for another way out.
That was fast.
Thank you.
So next would be Gemini Sigma, yeah? Voyager, Aedes Gamma. Yeah, finish it ko na yun. Let's try Gemini. Oh boy. MSB Worthington. Human design configured written passenger holding capable shutdowns thrusters are pulled to drift off the orbit of Antri. Time to explore.
Empty.
Most of the systems are shut down. It's just running on basic life support.
What's the difficulty this thing? Ay puñeta, por eso que le ven duro contra hardcore.
We're not alone. Trap.
That's the last of them.
Thank you. That machine's keeping him alive.
I'm not seeing any brain activity on the readouts. He's dead. This body is just an empty shell.
Maybe we should shut the machine down. It's the merciful thing to do.
It's your decision, Shepard. But maybe we should wait until we know more about what's going on before we do anything.
That's a sensible idea. First, I am going to loot.
Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die with dignity. It's what he would want. I'm more worried about Julia now. She's showing signs of severe depression. I gave her some meds that should help, but I better warn the captain.
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. Give her a chance to... Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
They say Jacob's gone. They say his brain isn't functioning anymore, and they want to shut off his machines. But Jacob's the only thing in the world that matters to me. I don't know how to help him, and it's tearing me up inside. I just feel so helpless, so damn angry. Dr. Smith gave me some meds to calm down, but I didn't take them. I can't. Not until I figure out a way to help Jacob. I won't give up on him. I won't!
I will destroy you!
Oh, take it easy.
Lock shields!
Jesus.
Think we're good, Commander? You did the right thing, Shepard.
Died.
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several reasons, I guess.
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments, or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taking my resignation pretty hard.
That's tough, but you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Saren.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right, or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Saren. He actually talked me out of becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
You were asked to be a Spectre?
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate. Me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits. I could have received special training, but my father didn't like it.
He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
I suppose I can understand his concern.
You can, But Saren's not going to play by our rules, C-Sex rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
Just because you can break the rules doesn't mean you should. I don't need to stoop to Saren's level to stop him. And neither do you, Garrus.
I see what you mean, but I'll think about it. Thanks, Commander.
Commander, you have a minute to talk?
I keep an open door policy. If you have any concerns, lay them on me.
All right. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens, Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
They may not serve the Alliance, Chief, but they're allies. At least as far as Saren goes.
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
You don't trust the Alliance's allies?
I'm not sure I'd call the Council races allies. We, humanity, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
Standing up for ourselves doesn't mean standing alone.
I don't think we should turn down allies. I just think we shouldn't bet everything on them staying allies. As noble as the Council members seem now, if their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
I don't see that as inevitable.
Look, if you're fighting a bear, and the only way for you to survive is to sick your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always be more important to them than humans are.
These seem like deeply held beliefs, Williams. What made you think this way?
My family's defended the Alliance since it was founded. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
I come from a military family, too. My parents were both Navy. Anybody in your family you might know?
Couldn't say, Commander. We probably have a lot in common. You join up to carry on the tradition?
No. The future of humanity is out here. There's so much we haven't seen yet.
Yeah. I still remember my first field exercise on Titan. When we hit mud, the reality hit me. I'm the first person who ever stood here. Then my drill instructor kicked me in the ass. I went face first into the muck. He spent the next 5 minutes chewing me out for gold breaking.
Don't tell me you had Gunny Ellison. He's the only one I know who uses that word to describe shirking duty.
Oh, Lord. You went to the Makapog boot camp, too? Yeah. Gunny Ellison's still reaming out recruits down there, kicking ass and using words like inveigle and pusillanimous.
It doesn't sound like you've worked with aliens before.
No, sir. Mainly I've been groundside, part of the surface garrison forces. I did get a rotation on a space station for training. Every Marine rifleman, every rifleman, ZG certified.
That's odd. Your record is spotless and your technical scores are exemplary. You should be serving with the fleet.
Anyway, that's why I haven't served with many aliens, Commander.
All right. I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission. You're going to have to work with aliens, like it or not.
It won't be a problem, Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
Would you kiss anyone I ordered you to?
That depends, sir. If you ordered me to kiss a superior officer, that would be a violation of the regs concerning fraternization. That would make it an illegal order. I'd be required to decline and relieve you of command. Sir.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Kinda wish you'd got there sooner, Commander. No offense, I appreciate the rescue. I just wish...
You wish we'd been able to save the rest of your unit?
Yes, sir. If I had been more alert, we wouldn't have been cut down by an ambush.
The Geth are perfect.
Sir, they have... I'll make sure it doesn't happen again.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, sir.
So, we've got Saren on the run.
It won't be long now. Saren's good, but I'm better.
Good. He's rotten. To the core. I could tell as soon as I met him.
Why didn't you tell me this sooner?
I would have if I thought I was important.
I think I'd like to hear about it just the same.
This was a while ago. A bunch of mercs were bragging about a job out near the edges of the Terminus systems. They said it paid well and the boss was never around to ride them. They said he was looking for more men, too. So I checked it out.
I didn't know Saren was openly recruiting mercs.
It wasn't that open, and he only showed his face once. We'd been raiding ships in the area for months when we took out this massive cargo freighter. Our biggest haul yet. I was on board checking bodies for valuables, looking for some extra credits. That's when I saw him.
What did Saren want with the ship?
I don't know what he wanted. He was just moving through the ship, watching. A couple of the mercs called him by name, but he never spoke to them. Never spoke to anyone. I had a really bad feeling about him, so I got the hell out. Didn't even wait to get paid.
Whose ship was it?
There was a Volus trading vessel. Big one. Lots of guards. But they were no match for us.
What kind of cargo was the freighter carrying? What was Saren after?
I don't know. All I saw on that ship was food and medical supplies. There were some basic weapons, but nothing big. If there was anything of value on that ship, I didn't see it. That's why I didn't mention it sooner.
That's the only time you saw him?
Yeah. Didn't even know who he was. Still wouldn't if I hadn't joined up with you. But my instincts were right. Every other merc on that mission turned up dead within a week. Every damn one.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Oh, hello, Shepard.
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me. Especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place. The Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
The silence wakes you up?
Back on the flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just a silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have until it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them, but maybe they just wanted a different life.
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually, but we have to stop Saren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
I should go.
See you later.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
30,000. Almost there. 115,000 to go?
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
If anyone has to take over for Captain Anderson, I'm glad it's you. I'm not sure about having non-humans on our ship, though.
We're all on the same team here, Presley.
With all due respect, sir, that's what they said about Nihilus. Look how that turned out.
I'm in charge here, Presley. I decide if we have non-humans on this vessel.
Yes, sir. Understood, sir.
Speak freely, Presley. I want to know if you have a problem with non-humans.
It's not that, Commander. Humanity has always handled its own problems. Saren attacked one of our colonies. We should be the ones to stop him. We don't need their help.
Some people think asking for help is a sign of weakness. That's just being stupid and stubborn. No matter how strong you are, allies can make you stronger.
I guess so. Maybe I'm just stuck in the old ways of thinking. But don't worry, Commander. This won't be a problem.
How did you end up assigned to the Normandy?
I signed up with the Alliance as a navigator right out of school. Following in my grandfather's footsteps, I guess. My first posting was on the Agincourt. We were at Elysium during the Skellion Blitz. A massive fleet of alien raiders hit the colony, trying to wipe it out. They had the numbers, but their ships were no match for an Alliance frigate. It was a slaughter. We couldn't even keep track of how many ships they lost.
How'd you end up on the Normandy?
I got my officer's commission after Elysium. Must have made an impression on the right people. Captain asked for me when he was picking his crew.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, sir.
There. Commander, something you need?
I have to go.
All right, see you.
Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Elena Blake is there.
Out. Thank you.
draw shields!
Not in my line of sight.
My line of sight. I've got a visual.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
This is a general distress call from the Sacred Angel Medical Transport. Critical system failure. Losing power. An emergency landing. Argos. Communications failing. Life support and emergency transponder. Won't last. Please hurry.
Thank you.
Coming from that wreckage.
Careful, Shepard. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, there's a trap!
What? Oh, shit. +231.
I know who runs this place.
Have you been here before?
No, but I was planning to come here before you and I met. This place belongs to a Turian scum named Ton Actus. It's a long story, but he's got something that belongs to me.
Well, what is it?
Family armor. It's been with us for over 5 generations. Turian military took it from my father's father after the war. Somehow this ass wound up with it. I want it back.
We'll get it back. Now let's move.
Right behind you.
Yeah. How tough is this? Idiot. I said hold, not charge. We're on.
Thank you.
Target in sight.
I lost contact.
Shot.
Say goodnight.
Go, go, go!
I can't get a lock.
They're in my sights.
Not acquired.
Go, go, go!
Target online.
Go, go! On my way.
I've lost contact.
Target not acquired.
Go, go!
On my way.
Se ti puta.
Go!
just fucking stupid.
This is it. I can't believe my ancestors ever wore this piece of crap, but at least I've got it back.
I'm glad we could help you get it back.
I might just be starting to like you, Shepard.
Thank you.
in sight.
Shields!
Hey, what's up, dude? Oh, thank you for the follow. To him. And Stacy.
Take cover! Go, go, go! go, go!
Shields!
I can't believe my ancestors ever wore this piece of crap, but at least I've got it back.
I'm glad we could help you get it back.
I might just be starting to like you, Shepard.
I can't get a lock. I need a target.
Contact.
Go, go, go!
Wait. It's the freaking marksman. Only available. Fire one round. Yeah, so where is it? Ah, here it is. Pardon. Armor equipment. Target. Captain. Stand up at Corberian. Who's out? Let's test this.
I'll kill you!
Enemy is everywhere!
I'll kill you! I'll kill you!
Enemy is everywhere!
Take him down!
Hold the line! Enemy is everywhere!
Take him down! Take him down!
Hold the line!
Take him down! Take him down! I'll kill you!
On Rex. Get out of
here. I lost shields.
Shit.
Thank you.
Take him down!
Nice.
Negative contact, Commander.
Knight armor, Guardia. Shield record. Gold sniper for discover evidence. Sorry, Lee. Slave. Pass it around, is it? Hi. Insufficient Omni Gel. you.
Thank you.
Commander.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, sir.
What do you want, Shepard?
Why did you become a mercenary?
Lots of reasons.
Such as?
What the hell?
Such as, I needed to get out of our system. I needed to eat. I needed to survive.
Why not stay and help your people?
I tried to help. That's why I had to leave.
What happened?
I was betrayed. I was head of a small tribe. We were trying to restore order after the war, but the other tribes were against us. They followed Jared, one of the few warlords who survived the war with the Turians. But he was old, and so were his ideas. He wanted to continue the war. He wanted us to fight. Turians, Salarians, each other. It didn't matter who, as long as we were fighting.
What did you want?
I just wanted Jared to shut up. To stop his ranting. I wanted him to stop leading the tribes astray. But he couldn't understand how much things had changed. We didn't have the numbers to go to war. Even if we did, the Genophage made sure we couldn't replenish our numbers fast enough. I told them all to forget about war. We needed to focus on breeding, at least for one generation. And for a while, we were getting through. Some of the tribes started coming around.
I take it the warlord didn't appreciate that.
No, he didn't. He arranged a crush with the tribes. A meeting on neutral ground. He wanted to talk. We met at the Hollows, near the graves of our ancestors. The skulls of our dead laid bare to remind us where we come from, and where we all go. It's as sacred as any Krogan place can be. Violence is forbidden.
It sounds like a trap to me. You must have suspected as much.
I did. But when your father invites you to a crush, well, there are some laws that even we hold sacred.
Jared was your father?
He was. Until that day. We talked, but we didn't get anywhere. When it was clear that I wouldn't join him, he gave the signal. His men leapt from the graves of our ancestors like Krogan undead. The few that were loyal to me died quickly. I escaped with my life, but not before I sank my dagger deep into my father's chest. That is why I left, and that's why I'll never go back.
You must have family other than your father. Don't you miss them?
No. Now that I have my family's armor again, there's nothing left for me.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Looking for supplies?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
$9,000, not bad.
Shepard, I'm glad you're here.
Good to see you smiling again, so to speak.
I'm sleeping much better now. I guess I'm getting used to how quiet your ship is. I still think a lot about my pilgrimage, though. I know Theron's our top priority, but with all the worlds we go to, I was hoping to find something to bring back to the flotilla.
We've still got a long way to go.
You'll find something to take back.
Yes, but it cannot just be some derelict ship my people can use for salvage. It has to be more than that. There's a lot expected of me.
What's so special about you?
It's my father. He's the senior member of the Admiralty Board. He's one of only 5 people who can overrule the decisions of the Conclave for the good of the Migrant Fleet. My father is responsible for the lives of 17 million people. Our entire race is in his hands, and I'm his only child.
So are you some kind of heir to the Quarian throne or something?
No, it doesn't work that way. My father's position isn't hereditary. I'll probably never serve on the Admiralty Board myself. Officially, I'm just the same as any other citizen. But it doesn't work that way in practice. People have always treated me differently because of who my father is.
You must get all kinds of special privileges.
I probably had it easier than most growing up, but it's not all good. People like my father have enemies, and they're not above using me to get to him.
It must be tough on you.
My people place a high value on family and ancestry. There's an unspoken expectation that I'll live up to my father's example. Everyone's waiting for me to do something great on my pilgrimage, something that will forever change our lives for the better. If I don't, it's like I failed, and that reflects badly on both me and my father.
The work you're doing here is more important than anything any Quarian has ever done before.
Yes, I know. But you have to understand Quarian culture. We're a very insular society. The events beyond the flotilla don't much matter to the average citizen. Our greatest dream is that one day, we'll return to our homeworld and drive out the Geth. But even if we stop Saren, that's not going to happen. There's still millions of Geth behind the veil. Until they're gone, our exile will continue.
What would you need to bring back to make everyone happy?
Something that would help us better understand the Geth. They've changed significantly since the exile. They've continued to evolve. We've done our best to study them, but it's not easy. They're very reclusive. Until recently, they never went beyond the borders of the Vale. And all the Geth we run into now are under Saren's control. We'd need to find Geth operating on their own, independently. But I don't want this to get in the way of our mission, Shepard. First, we stop Saren. Then I'll worry about my own problems.
What was your father like?
It wasn't easy growing up as the daughter of one of the Admiralty. Even before he joined the board, he was a prominent figure. People looked to him for leadership. He had to set an example, and he expected the same of his daughter. Plus, he was pretty strict, a military man through and through. He never allowed me to settle for anything less than excellence. As a kid, I sometimes felt like he was pushing me too hard. But now, I'm old enough to appreciate what he taught me. The world doesn't owe us anything. If we want something in life, we have to earn it.
Where was your mother in all this?
Mother was around, but she always seemed to kind of blend into the background. Almost like she was overshadowed by my father. He tends to do that to people. She passed on about 5 years ago. Some airborne virus that swept through the fleet. Happens sometimes when the filters start to break down. I think my father took it pretty hard. After she was gone, he became even more focused on his work. I think that was his way of dealing with the grief.
Sounds like a tough upbringing. You don't resent your father at all?
Like I said, it wasn't easy. My father's not the kind of person you bond with. And he wasn't around all that much. Too busy. People counted on him, and he took his duties seriously. Even when he was around, he always seemed a bit distant. Like his mind was always somewhere else. Come to think of it, I can't ever remember seeing him smile. Not once. It's like he was always weighed down by all that responsibility. I mean, I know he cares about me, but he never really showed it, not in the usual way. I guess the best thing I can say about my father is that I respect him.
I want to talk about something else.
Like what?
I should go.
See you later.
Commander, I'm picking up a signal from the planet's surface. It looks like an automated distress beacon.
Cover me.
Alliance soldiers. Looks like they were lured here by the distress beacon.
Looks like these men were under Admiral Kahuku's command. He'd want to know what happened here.
These two is done. Aedes Gamma Beta Forset Nebula.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
In entertainment news, Francis Kitt has announced plans to direct Hamlet with Elcor cast members. The production will open dramatic theater to the Elcor with a Hamlet who uses Elcor body language and pheromones. Kit claims that he's also excited by giving a human audience the chance to judge Hamlet by his deeds and not his emotions.
I'm waiting.
Commander, any word on my missing men?
I'm not sure how to tell you this, Admiral. Your men were killed by a Thresher Maw.
A Thresher Maw? That's not... My men wouldn't just stumble into a Thresher nest. Not the entire unit.
Somebody lured them there with an Alliance distress beacon. Placed it perfectly so they'd land right beside the Thresher nest.
Damn it. I had a bad feeling about this ever since my team disappeared. An Alliance beacon used as bait, my unit wiped out, and nobody seems to know anything about it. Commander, I appreciate what you did. Now I need to do my part. The families of those Marines deserve to know why they died.
Anything you need from me?
Not right now, Shepard, but I'll let you know as soon as I find something out.
I know you. You're Commander Shepard, the Human Spectre. Is there something I can do for you?
You're Nasana, right? I ran into your sister, Dahlia. It didn't end well for her.
What? Are you saying she's...
Dahlia's dead, Nasana, and I know she was blackmailing you.
And I was all set to try to manipulate you into hunting her down for me. But I guess that won't be necessary now, will it?
You wanted your sister dead?
If people found out my sister was a criminal, I'd be considered a security risk. They'd revoke my clearance, or place me on administrative leave until she was apprehended. I shall transfer a little something into your account as a token of my appreciation. I'm sure you'll find the amount satisfactory.
You're a diplomat on her way up the ranks. It could be handy to have a Spectre who owes you a favor.
You make a good point. Anyone can come up with credits. But I can give you authorization to purchase prototype Asari mods. I will get you added to our manufacturer's preferred client list. I think you'd be very interested in what they have available. Goodbye, Shepard. It has been a pleasure doing business with you.
Welcome back, Earth Clan. Will you
show me what you've got?
Most excellent.
There are rumors on the extranet that you've been made the first human Spectre. That's incredible.
Being a Spectre is a big responsibility. I just want to make humanity proud.
The vids are all talking about Commander Shepard fighting for all of us back home. And they also say that you don't take crap from anybody. You're showing them what humans can do. Hey, can I get your picture?
I don't have a problem with it, but why?
You're a hero, Shepard. Decades from now, humanity's going to remember you, and I'll have your picture. Just hold up your gun. Perfect. Thanks again, Commander. I'm gonna hang this in my living room. My wife will love it.
Celebrations are being planned for the anniversary of the end of the Rachni Wars. Many Council worlds, particularly Asari and Salarian colonies, will hold victory parades to commemorate the defeat of the invading Rachni. In a rare admission of debt, several Asari colonies have invited Krogans to be honored for the victories the uplifted Krogans made possible.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Hmm.
Message for you, Commander. Just came in over a secure channel.
Shepard, this is Admiral Kahoku. I found out who set that trap for my men. The ones killed by the Threshamore. Damn, I hope you get this message. It was a group called Cerberus. An Alliance Black Ops organization. Top secret, highest level security clearance. They vanished a few months ago. Dropped right off the grid. Nobody knew where they went or what they were up to. They've gone completely rogue, Shepard. They're conducting illegal genetic experiments, trying to create some kind of super soldier. I don't have any proof, but I found the coordinates for one of their research worlds. I'm uploading them with this message. They're completely out of control. Somebody needs to stop them. I've done my part. Now it's up to you. This is probably the last you'll hear from me. Cerberus is after me now. I need to disappear before they find me.
Commander, I'm picking up some strange reading. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
fool punches a NAFAC in the mouth, we should sneak around and pull its tail.
Plus Sina Juan. Healing it on foot times 3. Oh yeah. Okay. Level 16. Actually good.
Only a fool punches a NAFAC in the mouth. We should sneak around and pull its tail.
Nice. There you go.
Good to go, Shepard.
Sayang ang 280 XP. Nice. 17-6. Can I say?
Fine.
Wow. Actually, continue this later or tomorrow. I'm hungry.